School guys work.
Để bà cho lỡ, xin để bà cho lỡ đấy. Không khoa bị chơi nặng tay đang rung sân mà. Rung á, bóp. Lật lên. Lên con xin, cầm lên chân lên. Lên con. Vui. Cơn đặt đặt chân lên cho, đặt chân tam cho. Xin cầm cho. Đang này. Gạt tay, gạt tay. Đừng bóp, tay vui thành bóp. Đừng bóp ai luôn. Xin ngớp cho mà
cho
watch out your fingers. No holding, work, work.
Rồi ba có phải là trung. Nâng này, nâng, 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 nâng. À chương tao anh đặt cho, cùng cho chứ. Đang. À rút cây mà, cùng tục cây tên đây anh ý. Vậy mà, rừng mốc.
Rừng mốc, no holding, no holding, work.
Đặt chương cho. Đang. Rừng mốc, rút cây. Lạc một chùm hiếm, chương chơi được lạc mà. Lạc một chùm hiếm mà, chương chơi. Chôm một chùm hiếm. Xin ngớp, ngớp, xin châu, à. À, chóng mình, chóng mình, chóng mình. Xin, bài ba con tụt trung, bài ba con tụt trung. À, tiết, 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 tiết. Người con tụt lơ, xin người con tụt lơ.
Ai, great, stand up. Ai, ready, ready, fight! Don't grab the shot! Don't grab the shot! Don't grab the shot! Let's go, work to finish! Let's go, work to finish. Work to finish. Let's go, work, work to finish.
So many days, Zin. So, Zin, 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 Zin,
ផលនៅក្នុងការប្រកួតរយៈពេល 4 នាទី 32 វិនាទីក្នុងទឹកទី 1 អញ្ញាកណ្ដាលបញ្ឈប់ការប្រកួតជ័យជំនះនិងបានឡើងទៅវគ្គដៃព្រាត់ Grand Prix បានទទួលមកគោលគៀវចាន់រតនា
Here we go, karate against Kung Khmer. This should be a very interesting battle.
Both men leading with their left hand, so orthodox stance. Leaping in with that right hand, Rothana. Landed short.
Ooh, wow. Missed the jumping, spinning back kick and ended up on the ground here. He's got the half guard. As Rothana is working to pass.
I do believe it kicked it, that spinning kick, though. But his momentum took him down.
Look for the pass. Take your time. Get half guard. Don't step guard. I want half guard.
He could step over that half guard, but he's back into full guard now.
It's Rothana with his back to the mat in the black shorts and the ponytail there. Plaited ponytail. On top, it's Chan. Sorry, it's Gonzales, and on top is Chan Rothana.
Up the sweep. Gonzales is back on top in the half guard of Rothana. Let's see what the ground game looks like. Stuck inside the half guard.
Very close quarters here. Not much room for any punches to be exchanged.
Let's go, guys, work.
Cheek to cheek, aren't they? Not much dancing going on, though.
Rothana back into full guard, elevates. He's trying to go for an old plata, maybe it looks like. Oh, passes the guard. Gonzales on top in side control. Gonzales looking to drop some elbows from this position.
Let's go, guys.
Just 10 feet away from us, cage side here in Stadium Putra. Got a good crowd here, although it's still early in the evening, but already they're packed in. Knee on the forehead.
Trying to use his feet. Oh, back to the feet. Gets a single leg.
It's Rothana pushing Gonzales up against the cage. Furious commentary coming from the corner men as well.
Gonzales is defending
well.
Grab
the fence, we'll grab the fence.
Rothana's got him in a front headlock here.
Now what can he do with it? With his back against the cage.
Don't grab the shot. Don't grab the shot. Don't grab the shot.
Olivier Coste telling the fighters not to grab the shorts of the opponent. Also not allowed to grab the cage there, which,
all right, guys, which
Gonzales does
all right,
do
guys,
that.
Ready? Fight!
Of course, if you grab the cage, you can work your way, get a bit more leverage than you need. There's that spinning back kick again. Bit lower that time. Hasn't worked out too well for him on either occasion.
He ate a big shot there. He's trying to sweep, trying to elevate the legs. There you go, gets out, going for a heel hook, it looks like. More of an Achilles lock. He doesn't. So he has the foot there and he's trying to go for a straight foot lock.
Took a few blows to the face in the process, but he's definitely got the advantage.
Rothana is trying to roll out of it.
It's okay for that.
Punches to the chest. And up there to the face. Oh, it takes a heel to the head. That would hurt.
He's not letting go of that foot. He's trying to finish from there.
Oh, he slipped out. He took a few hammer blows to the head there and a number to the chest. But in the end, it was to no avail. Trying to get hold of that leg again.
He seems versed in the footlocks, but he's got to try to extend back. He's eaten a lot of punches by doing that. Oh, up on top, full mount, raining the shots down.
Ground and pound coming from left and right, not just straight down. That's how to beat the guard. Come from the side. Vary the angle of the punches here. Elbows to the neck and to the ear. The punches come down again, and Olivier Coste has seen enough. Very, very good variety in the ground and pound there. Straight down, yes, but also from the sides. And that means that the the defender on his back has to switch that guard around all the time and constantly be thinking and be aware of where those punches are coming from. And as we always see in this sport, great respect between the two combatants.
Great show. You can just see from the top position, he's just raining down, splitting the guard with the elbows, following up with the punches, and Olivia Costa has seen enough and jumps in.
There was nothing coming back from Rothana, doing his best to defend himself. But not only do you have to do that intelligently, occasionally you've got to throw something back.
A lot more groundwork than I expected.
That was plenty there and some intriguing footlocks. Here's Anthony Suntai.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Olivier Cost calls to halt this battle at 4 minutes 48 seconds of round number one for your winner by a referee stoppage due to strikes, Chan Rothana!
Thank you. សម្រាប់គូនេះគឺជាគូសងសឹកឥឡូវនេះក្នុងវគ្គនេះក៏មានកម្មវិធីពិសេសដែរគឺមានការផ្តល់ជូននៅក្នុងវគ្គនេះមានការប្រគល់រង្វាន់ពីកិត្តិយសរបស់យើងគឺលោកណានូបាតូសជាអ្នករៀបចំនិងរៀបចំកម្មវិធីនៃ Bantaleu! Kill the blue Chan Rothana!
Abro Fernandez 7-0 undefeated in the black and red. Rothana, the Cambodian Kung Khmer stylist in the black and yellow. Kung Khmer, very similar to Muay Thai. It's the national martial art of Cambodia. Big power salvo strikers. Thrust out the jab there, there's Abro Fernandez. Rothana looks for the inside leg. A tentative start from both men, just dipping their toes in the proverbial water here.
Action.
Overall experience goes the way of Chan Rothana, but in the cage, 7-0, Abro Fernandez. Oh, nice flurry down the center corridor from Fernandez. You better believe the lead hand. The final punch stung Chan Rothana.
Fernandez has good footwork. He closes the distance very quickly. He has a nice little shuffle step that he uses to get in there, and that's how he landed that hook. I'd like to see him put more of that jab out there. Get something in the face of Chan Rothana. Don't let him start to get comfortable in that striking mentality.
Already saw an earlier high right roundhouse kick from Rothana. We'll try and bring as much of that Kung Khmer as he can do in the cage here, Chan Rothana. The crowd rally every time one of these two athletes lands. In addition to that Kung Khmer background, but also the Yuvakun Khan Taekwondo background on Chan Rothana, who gets back to his feet here.
Okay, nice little scramble from both these guys. Chan Rothana's got to separate that grip. Nice little body lock takedown there from Fernandez. I think Chan Rothana could just stand up right here. He just gets that right leg underneath him. Oh, there he goes. Now he's back up. Still got that body lock. Chan Rothana's got to break that hand. He's got to break those hands. Now he's trying to separate him. But as he tries to separate, that's when Fernandez comes underneath and takes him for a ride.
Abro Fernandez trying to take the back of Chan Rothana after wrenching him to the canvas from the belly to back a couple of times. Pressed up against the cage now. Rothana glances up at the big screen to gauge how much time's left. There's 2:20 remaining. First round set for 3 minutes.
Oh, look how Rothana, look how Fernandez is underneath the arm. He's trapped that right arm there of Chan Rothana. That's going to open up the right side of his body. Now he's starting to land those shots.
Wrist control from Abro Fernandez. Rothana throws a knee to the upper left rib cage. They go to ground now. Half guard position for Fernandez. High knee. Maybe the stern in there from Fernandez. Takes the back standing here. What does Rothana do from here, Mitch?
Rotana's got to separate those hands. Now he's trying to, you know, break those hands. A little bit of hand fighting going on right there. But Fernandez is doing a good job of changing his grip. Every time Rotana's able to try to get something or separate the hands, that's when Fernandez starts to advance. Now they're back in the center. And looks like Rothana got a little bit more aggression behind him.
Great punch combination there from Rothana. Great crowd already inside the Axiata Arena for our prelim show. And they are loving all the action of this one. Good left hand there. Smack bang on the kisser from Chan Rothana.
This is where Rotana's got to keep his emotions in check. This is where he might start getting overzealous with his punches. And Fernandez might be able to duck under, get that body lock again, and drag him back down to the ground. Nice leg kick.
Outside of the key to a left hook there from Chan Rothana. Now finding his confidence, finding his range in the striking. Those big Kung Khmer leg kicks from the Cambodian are taking their toll on Abro Fernandez. And another one to the lead quadriceps.
And he's running into that leg kick like he's kicking a penalty kick in football or soccer. some of the world probably knows it as.
And Mitch Chilson clearly doesn't watch enough football. High left roundhouse kick here from Rotana. Two-punch combination from Fernandez, but look at Rotana walking him down, constantly coming forward, goes for an outside crescent kick, and Fernandez locks him up, presses him against the cage. This is electrifying stuff.
That's where Fernandez does his best work. He's able to duck under the punch, get that body lock, and he's looking to drag him back down to the canvas. Rotana's doing a good job of creating separation, threatened the clinch, pushed away.
Fernandez on the back foot, and Rotana tries to take his head off with that final kick. One round down, two remaining. It's our prelim show live from Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia.
Rotana was able to turn it on at the end of that round, but a lot of that first chunk of the round came from Fernandez, blitzing forward, throwing those hands. Look at this. Evaded the kick and comes right forward with that big straight right hand. Rotana, after a tough first couple of minutes, was able to shake that off and start to get more aggressive with his striking and start to put the heat on it. But again, he's got to keep those emotions in check. He's still got to keep the movement. He just can't push forward like that, because that's when Fernandez is able to come underneath, get that body lock, and start looking for those trips to bring him to the ground.
Don't forget to check out our official online store, all the latest One Championship fashion wear. And we are ready to rock and roll, second round of three. At the start of the first round, it was Abro Fernandez seemingly in control, but then the striking, the Kunkumai stallions of Chan Rothana took over. Look out for that back leg of Chan Rothana. And that's one way to negate it. Get him on his back. This crowd is loud.
Good movement on top from Fernandez. But even though Rotana gives up a takedown, he has been able to get back up to his feet. Fernandez needs to do a better job of holding him down. See, look how he's scrambling out. Now he sinks in the hooks on the back. Now he's trying to flatten him out. Now this is where Fernandez is dangerous. Look for him to drop some heavy bombs.
Rotana trying to survive here. Fernandez in control in the early get-go of this second round as the back of the Cambodian.
He's a bit high on the back. Rotana could be able to shake him off and sneak out the back door. Fernandez needs to get a little bit lower. He's trying to stand up, but Fernandez does a good job with those hooks. See how he's controlling the legs there with the inside of his feet? Now he's bringing that right arm right across the chin. It's more of a face crack. Might be able to get in the
Oh, is this it? Is this the end for Chan Rothana?
Nah, he's going to be okay. He's got that hand. See how he's defending with the left hand? Fernandez was able to get it back up. Let's see who ends up on top of the scramble, though.
As the back again, there's Ebro Fernandez going to slide down. Yes, he does. Now Rothana top position. Here comes the ground and pound from the Cambodian. This place going bananas!
Good defense so far from Fernandez. He's not taking a lot of damage. He's utilizing the feet on the hips to create a little space. And a lot of these shots aren't getting through. But just give Chan Rothana a matter of time. If he keeps picking these shots, eventually he's going to land a big one.
Body shot there from Rotana, then goes back up to Fernandez's jaw. Back to the belly button. Fernandez tries for the up kick.
Let's go.
Amethyst try, missed the target for Rotana. It is deafening in the Axiata Arena. This is only the second match of our prelims. And there's no Malaysian in the ring. Oh, big right hand smack bang for Rotana!
Don't kick.
Abro in trouble. Rotana, a house on fire. Halfway through the second round. The ferocity of the Cambodian.
These exchanges are taking a tremendous toll on their energy expenditure. Chan Rothana said he spent a lot of time working on his gas tank, making sure that when he gets involved in these aggressive, exciting matches, he wants to have the gas tank to deliver all his techniques.
Fernandez is cut. His hands are low. He's breathing through his mouth. He is tired. Can Rothana finish it here? Fernandez may be right for the picking. He runs away from Rotana. Rotana on the front foot. Kim Cheng saying to engage. Rotana comes forward. Goes for a rip kick. Tries to pull the head down. the stack, the pepper isn't there for Ambrose Fernandez now. Big left hand from Rotana. Fernandez drifts back to center cage. He can't lift his hands up. Rotana takes his time. In control, the Cambodian. High right roundhouse kick for Headache Maker. Left hook to a right hand, good combination from the Cambodian.
A smart move by Fernandez, but he can't stick the takedown. Rotana able to pop back up, and you can definitely see Rotana looks like a fresher athlete. That gas tank is definitely there for Rotana as we're approaching the last minute of this very action-packed round. Look at Fernandez just taking big shots from Rotana. Rotana's patient, big knee.
Oh, the high knee! The crown impaled! The good night, Irene! Team Cambodia ends the year 2-0 here in Kuala Lumpur.
What a great show by Chan Rothana. He said his gas tank was full, and it was. He had that energy deep into the second round and was able to put it on Fernandez after a very tough first round, Michael Cervello. Look at Chan Rothana sensing that. You can see Fernandez start to wilt, landed a big knee, drops Fernandez, and then Rothana jumps all over him till Kemp Chang's forced to jump in and stop the show.
That is a huge win for Chan Rothana, a huge win for Cambodia. All of our fans watching in Cambodia on the One Super app. I know they all watch it there. Your flag is flying proudly in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia tonight. Team Cambodia finished 2-0 here with wins back-to-back for Savannah M and Chan Rothana, both by TKO. Let's go to Dom Lau, make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kent Chang, has called a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 6 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Chan Rothana!
休息一下，多休息一下，缓过来再说。缓一下，多缓一下，多缓一下。 对不对？对，二百三十多万。
That's Chilson alongside Gianni Suba. Nice leg kick landed by Rui Agustin as he works back into against the ropes as Chan Rothana. Chan Rothana
double underhooks. If they're gonna step outside, gets the sweep.
As he looks inside the guard of Chan Rothana. This is exactly where Chan Rothana did not want to be. On his back with a ground and pound specialist, Agustin throwing bombs on him.
Chan Rothana staying very active on the ground, landed those short elbows.
Chan Rotana's got very active elbows. He's got sharp elbows. He's finished a lot of people in Kung Kumai with those elbows. Look for him to throw him here right immediately on his back.
Rudy Agustin doing a good job of keeping his head in the middle, trying to get inside bicep position. Like you see, Chan Rotana's doing a great job. Holding his head down, controlling the left arm, the right arm of Rudy Agustin. Not allowing any strikes from Agustin.
He's controlling the head, fighting off the bicep. Nice little throw there as he tries to throw a possible arm bar. He's gonna get his hips a little bit more out to the side. He can't throw that arm bar up with his hips in the middle of Agustin's guard like this.
Chan Rothana needs to have his hips swiveled, needs to have his hips on one side. Have a little bit more leverage. Rudy looks content to stay in the guard here, not looking too much to pass.
Well, he knows just how explosive Chan Rothana is. So if he does try to create that little bit of space, he knows that Chan Rothana is going to start to frame off the hips like he's doing with his feet, push away, and get back up to his feet.
Chan Rothana with the right foot on the hip there, creating a little bit of space. Not sure what he wants to do, but Rudy Agustin looks to push down on the leg and pass.
Almost able to do it.
Rudy Agustin goes to the back.
Very sneaky move by Rudy Agustin to pass.
Oh, hooks it. Great job of Chan Rothana rotating inwards, stopping the advancement of Agustin. Rothana with an underhook of his own right now. He's got a lot of experience in Kung Kumar, so he knows what to do in the clinch.
Good job working his way, turns back to the corner. Possibly looking to separate here. Rudy Agustin does not want to let this chance go. He's got that clinch. Wants to keep it nice and tight.
Wants to look for the double underhook and look for the little outside trip that he got in the beginning of the round.
Like that short little elbow. Chan Rothana threw as he lands a nice right hand.
Rothana striking real well, really well off the break here.
Chan Rothana likes to stay a little bit flat-footed because he throws so much power into that right hand. So you can see him plant his feet right in front of his opponent. And what that does is it gives Agustin the opportunity to close that distance real quick.
Chan Rothana looked for a little clinch sweep right there, but ends up on his back. Rudy Agustin passes on the left side already.
He's got to be a little bit tighter in his escapes. He's got to make sure he does the right things when he tries to move away. He can't just try to get up sloppy like that because Rudy Agustin has just got, all he has to do is fall forward, which is what he did.
Right. Chan Rothana here still has half guard. 1 foot on the hip there. Chan Rothana's foot on the hip is stopping the advancement of Agustin. Agustin wants to slide to the left side, go into side control, but Chan Rothana's doing a great job of framing with his legs, not allowing the advancement of the pass by Agustin.
You can see the foot on the hips right there, which is what Giant Soup is talking about. He's not allowing Agustin to take that left leg and slice through the middle of Chan Rothana's leg. Nice ground and pound thrown by Rudy Agustin.
This is where Agustin wants to keep the bout. He wants to keep the bout with him grappling, not allowing Rothana inside in the double leg. Look at these finishes. Chan Rothana does a good job of sprawling, getting his hips back.
Ball, but Chan Rothana's got to move. Cannot stand right in front of Rudy Agustin. He's looking for that one big shot. But Rudy Agustin is relentless in his takedown attempts. Good job by Chan Rothana to stay back up, though.
You can see Rothana is not conceding position. As soon as he gets taken down, Rothana is looking to pop back right away.
Rudy Agustin might be starting to fatigue a little bit. All these constant takedown attempts are starting to wear him down a little bit. He's also demoralizing him because the way that Chan Rothana is able to pop back up. Look at Chan Rothana.
As Agustin starts to fatigue, it will open up the strikes for Chan Rothana. That was a high face set by Rudy Augustin. Let's see if he can keep it up for the next two rounds.
Look at this. He's constantly getting back up. But that's what Chan Rothana worked on. He worked on his strength and conditioning because he knew this was going to go.
Now you can see that Augustin does a great job of moving past the guard of Chan Rothana. Goes to the back, but Rothana does a great job of rotating in and stopping the hooks of Augustin from going in.
You gotta wonder about the gas tank of Rudy Augustin. Just the look on his face after that takedown attempt that was stuffed by Chan Rothana, he just seemed a little bit deflated.
Yep, that's very demoralizing, as you said, Mitch. Every defended attempt is a win for Chan Rothana. Chan Rothana is gaining confidence with each successful takedown defense of his.
That's when Chan Rothana gets so dangerous, is when he gets that confidence flowing and he starts throwing those heavy shots. As Chan Rothana just tried to look into the soul of Rudy Augustin as he glared through the corner at him. Look at that. Nice little straight right hand to a left hook combination. See, Chan Rothana starting to get a little bit light on his feet. Now he's starting to move around a little bit. Not so flat-footed, not so planted.
Rothana knows that Rudy Augustin is fading a little bit, so he's using his footwork here, not allowing Augustin to time it for the takedown.
Chan Rothana misses on a big leg kick as he lets out a little wail. Rudy Augustin lets him know he appreciates that shot right there. As soon as Rudy Augustin closes that distance, gets into that striking range, Chan Rothana throws a big right hand.
Chan Rothana is not afraid to throw combinations in three rounds. He has the conditioning to do that.
Like that body kick, like how he's starting to work in this way. Rudy Augustin might be starting to fade. There's no takedown attempts coming. Nice hand combination thrown by Chan Rothana.
This is what Rudy Augustin wants. Rudy Augustin wants Chan Rothana to commit on the striking exchange and look to another chain drop it.
Looks to be the fresher of the two as we're approaching the 3-minute mark of the second round of this mixed martial arts contest. Like the leg kicks, like Chan Rothana throwing those leg kicks, it's gonna slow down that shot attempt coming from Rudy Augustin. Now he's throwing that uppercut from way back from Phnom Penh.
Chan Rothana doing a great job of doing long range strikes, not overcommitting, not allowing Rudy Augustin the space to clinch up.
Nice little fake there. Beautiful left kick, straight right hand combination. This is not the same Rudy Augustin that we saw in the first. He expended a lot of takedown as he runs right into a knee.
You have to think, Mitch, is Rudy Augustin trying to conserve energy for the third round, trying to push hard? Not a good strategy against Chan Rothana, who's known to be able to go three rounds.
And Chan Rothana's pacing him apart right now as he catches the kick, throws him to the ground. Here comes the ground and pound by Chan Rothana. Oh, Rudy Augustin's got a move. Chan Rothana's gonna go right past this guard. Might end up in side control or mount. Big right hand landing.
Augustin not doing much in terms of defense.
That's it. Chan Rothana.
He needs to lock up Chan Rothana here. He can't just defend.
He's got to intelligently defend himself. Otherwise, Kim Chang is being forced to jump in and stop this.
Try to slow down the attacks of Chan Rothana. Try to get it under her.
Good job. At least Chan Rothana was still able to lock in a guillotine. Chooses to switch around, take the back, keeps punching. Beautiful stoppage. Chan Rothana found his moment and let Rudy Augustin know. It was the takedown. It was the ability to stop the takedown, get up from the takedown. And then once he had Rudy Augustin broken, he jumped all over him with huge ground and pound.
Rudy
what
Augustin
a victory.
Pushed a little bit too hard in the first round. Didn't gauge his conditioning. Put too much on the first round, and Chan Rothana poured on the pressure in the second round. Kept his range really well. Never allowed any opportunity for Rudy Augustin to get his grappling in. And as soon as Chan Rothana took him to the ground, landed a barrage of strikes. Rudy Augustin covering up here, not intelligently defending himself. Here, on the back position, unanswered right hands. Referee has no choice but to stop this bout.
Impressive performance from Chan Rothana. Let's go to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kemp Cheng, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 50 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Chan Rothana!
I'm always excited for these. Love good classic matchups. See, starting heavy. Good right hand, slam at the back. Absolutely no feeling process, feeling out process from these two. Beautiful takedown by Xie.
Nice little trip there by Xie Wei as he ends up in side control here.
Liu's got to start scrambling. He's got to start moving. Good job on the adjustment of the hand. Look how he's driving that shoulder into the chin there, trying to turn his head away so he can't escape out. But Liu's trying to get in. He's got to deal with that underhook on that one, on that left side. He's got to try to get that underhook. Which is, now he's just secured the overhook.
Now CE is in a great position here to drop those elbows. See, yeah, you see as he's keeping that pressure with the that forearm and also the underhook here. That's key. That is absolutely key. He has the control as long as he has that far side underhook.
You see him trying to frame off that head, but a good job by Liu to try to bury his head into the stomach there to avoid any shots. But just that framing off, that constant pushing from Xie. Doing a good job of controlling the exchange here in the ground. Oh, elbow.
Yeah, landing some good knees. Followed up by those busy punches. Oh, he's looking to trap that arm there. Now this is a, what we call a crucifix position. If he's able to lock both arms in place, there's absolutely no way for Liu to defend. Liu feeling that sense of urgency to get out of that. Nice scramble by Liu.
Good job by Xie Wei on a top position. I was wrong calling him just a kung fu striker. The Shaolin Temple got me a little bit excited because this guy is a well-rounded mixed martial artist.
Well, now he's been doing this since he's 14. I mean, he's been training martial arts, landing a lot of punches here, and able to stay in dominant position. This may be it.
That's a tap due to strikes right there. Xie Wei, welcome to One Hero Series.
Liu protesting a bit there, saying it looked like he was signaling to the back of the head there, but I didn't really catch any illegal blows, so I just think the pressure really was getting to him too much. Yeah. Let's look at the replay here. So we have Xie transitioning to the back there, throwing those good punches. Yeah, no, he's good. He's, those are all legal punches. Those are all landing, at least touching the ear. That's the general rule, that part of the glove has to connect with the ear. Those were all legal.
Yeah, it looked like he was actually trying to tap or at least think about it possibly, but a huge win out of the red corner from Xie Wei.
Southwest dance on the line. Outside low kick from Barat. Gives away 20 centimeters in height to Chan Rothana. Big looping attack from the Cuban.
Gustavo Barat has used that big monstrous left hand to drop opponents in the past. You can see him trying to set that up. I think it's actually the height advantage of Chan Rothana puts him at a huge risk for that monstrous left hand of Ballard's. Trying to close that distance. There's that knee. There's that beautifully timed knee by Chan Rothana, but he's catching on the chin there from Ballard.
King Kamaya, the national martial art of Cambodia. Big takedown there from the Greco-Roman wrestler. Tries to put him through the canvas. Closes the guard as Chan Rothana. Having the big takedown there from Gustavo Ballard. El Gladiator. Inside the close guard here of Rothana.
See, Chan Rothana's trying to get the feet on the hips, but you know, again, you know, those long legs are having a hard time getting inside. on the guard. So Chan Rothana is going to have to try to adjust and try to change up his guard a little bit. Now he passes into half guard. Big right hand. Oh, he gives up his back, though. See what Pilar can do here. He's almost secured the back. Let's see if he can take that left leg over and sink in that hook, but he doesn't quite need it from this position.
Tremendously powerful individual, Gustavo Pilar. Rothana pops the head out. Pilar back onto a double leg, looking for another takedown. The Cuban switches to a single leg here.
High crotch, elevates, good balance by Rothana, but up he goes.
Oh, going for a ride! Still has him up in the air. Boom, shakalaka.
Nice takedown there from Pollard as he just paused in midair. Photographer's gift as he just kind of posed for a picture before he tried to put Chan Rothana through the center circle there.
Into the side of the head here from Gustavo Pollard, putting on a show in the opening round is Chan Rothana of Cambodia.
Strong and so top-heavy. Talking to Wada, who's his last opponent, he could not believe the strength of Gustavo Pilar. Chan Rothana is experiencing that right now. Good little turn, goes for the single leg. Good job by Chan Rothana to stand back up as Rothana says, no big deal. Ah, there's that knee.
Hooking punch there from Pilar on the front foot. Oh, big left hand from Pilar. And again from Gustavo Pilar, the overhand left. Walks into a knee.
Timing there on that knee again from Rothana. Pilar ate it, walked right through it. Gets inside that pummel now. See if he changes levels, drops down.
The 2012 Olympian needs to watch the knees of a Krug Kamai stylist. Bounces back to center circle. High right ground pass there from Chan Rothana. Rothana make it three wins in a row. And Gustavo Pilar with his first win in the championship. Action counter from the Cuban.
1 minute left in the first round.
Scoops up the roundhouse from Rothana.
Rothana's definitely trying to find a home for that right kick of his. He's throwing it in a way that is drawing up his knee so he can kind of catch Robart as he's coming in. If he chooses to stay on the end of the kick, he catches the kick. If he comes in, he catches the knee.
Rothana's shaking his head. Saying to Pilar, I've taken heavier shots in Krug Kamai. You're not going to knock me out with your hands. But Pilar does pack tremendous power.
He's doing a good job of keeping the distance in that kicking range.
House from Rothana. Rushed forward, didn't commit to anything though. Front kick from Rothana. Hitting right hook there from Rothana. Throws his hands up, trying to suck a Gustavo Pilar in. Into the first round, we go to the towels.
Check out the timing on this knee right here. Beautifully done. Right there as Pilar came in, Rothana shot the knee up and then caught him right there on the shoulder. But then Pilar was able to close that distance, pick up Rothana, and put him down in that beautiful double leg. But then there was that a very nice takedown as he picks him up, adjusts the position correctly, and then sets Rothana down emphatically on his back. Beautifully done in side control. Very patient there from Ballard. He's used to those types of takedowns, so it's not a lot of energy expenditure. But now it's going to come down to that second round. Who's got the most gas? Rothana pops up off the stool, ready to go.
Second round of action. Set for three. Use the hashtag Dreams of Gold. We are one. Let us know where you're watching from around the world. It's One Championship live from Bangkok, Thailand. Big hello to Britt McCloskey watching Australia. Roundhouse kick there from Chan Rothana of Cambodia. The only Cambodian on tonight's card, the only Cuban on tonight's card, Gustavo Pilar. Our only Cuban in One Championship, bitch. An overhand left from Gustavo Ballart. Inside the guard here of Rothana. One foot on hips from the Cambodian.
Rothana was going to the head kicks on the right side, but then when he changed things up and he went for that outside leg kick on the left side, that's what gave Ballart the opportunity to catch the leg kick and put him on his back.
Open guard, foot on hips here, Rothana throws a little elbow. Ballart looks to return the favor. Rothana back to his feet. Tried for the clinch and knee to Chan Rothana. There's another one from the Cambodian. Double leg attempt from Ballart. Elbow from Rothana. Ballart wants to pick him up and plant him. And happening at the moment though.
Good takedown defense. You can see Ballard's trying to dig under that leg again, send him up to the ride. But good takedown defense here in the second. Rothana.
Ball stance, good looking at there for Gustavo Ballart.
Rothana's gonna kick, that's where he needs to do it. I'd like to see maybe go to the body of Ballart as well.
Nice roundhouse kick, tucks it under the left arm of Ballart. They are gonna burst a blood vessel in the corner of Gustavo Ballart, barking all sorts of instructions to Cubans. Rothana ties him up, tries to pull the head down for the meet and greet knee. Throws a knee, sprawls out. Looping overhand left there from Gustavo Ballart, but couldn't commit. Roundhouse from Rothana. Ballart's got to be careful not to get sloppy with these spin arounds. Front kick from Rothana, missed the target. Ballart back to center circle, loops wildly with the right hand. Step through knee. Clinch there from Rothana. Ballart drives him back against the circle fence, picks him up. Second bite of the cherry, a little trip takes him down, ends up inside control.
Beautiful job by Ballart. Very aggressive on that takedown to make sure he got it. Now he's inside control here. Let's see if Rothana can dig that underhook on his right side and work his way back up to his feet. You can see he's kind of turned the wrong way. He's got to actually kind of turn onto his left side, so he can actually start digging with that underhook and get work his way back up. Might get him back here. There he goes. Now he's got it right. Ballart's got such a heavy top game. See, Rothana's trying to push him down into those knees.
Cuts the hip in here, does Ballart. 1 minute 25 remains, second of three, Cambodia versus Cuba. These two countries with Indonesia here often in the sporting world competing against each other. But here they are at the very top of the martial arts world. And a fantastic contest, overhook on the left arm of Ballart. Red there, you see, screaming instructions to those instructions for Chan Rothana. Turning back kick from Ballart, and a home run roundhouse from Chan Rothana. Front kick from Rothana sends him back, step through knee, gets tagged with the left hand.
You see the adjustments on the kicking game from Rothana. Now he's just kicking off that right side, going to the head, and that step through push kick as well. Ballart's gonna have to deal with that. He's not. So there he goes. Now he catches the kick on the other side. Good job by Rothana. Make sure he maintains that balance.
Spinning back fist from Gustavo Ballart and another one from Ballart. Can he go to the well one time too many? As Rothana punishes him with that left hand. Rothana comes forward now. Ballart throws the overhand left. There's a right hand smack back to Schnoz. Roundhouse kick from Rothana. Counter from Gustavo Ballart. The up kicks from Rothana. Ballart wants to go to ground with him. Is he going to get there, the cube? And he does now on one knee. Look at the side control. One more round to go.
Very intriguing second round there. Lots of back and forth action, but the story of that second round was the takedowns from Ballard against those kicks coming from Rothana. Rothana has done a good job of understanding the distance of Ballard and let go of a lot of those kicks. Now, a lot of them have been blocked, so they haven't really gotten through on Ballard, but the takedowns have scored as well. But you can just see the striking superiority coming from Chan Rothana. Chan Rothana's had over 200 kumkumai matches. Gustavo Ballard's had over 300 wrestling matches. There's a lot of experience in that inside the circle right now.
Such diversity amongst our many viewers around the world for one championship. An amazing viewership we have. A big hello to Usman Kamar watching on YouTube from Canada. Tweets and Facebook messages, YouTube messages on the Instagram, all coming through from fans all over the world. Rothana wants to hug it out. Gustavo Ballard will have none of that. Third and final round. Roundhouse kick from Rothana. Will the kumkumai specialist turn up the striking now? Fake downstairs from Ballard. There's a nice front kick from Rothana. Then switches to a roundhouse kick. Looking punches off that power laden left hand from Gustavo Ballard. Rothana. Front kick to a roundhouse kick. Seems to be the bread and butter combination work from Chan Rothana. The push kick off the lead foot, the roundhouse kick off the back foot. As he go toe to toe with Ballard. Ballard onto another overhand left. Front kick, double front kick from Rothana. Jab two, Ballard got under the number two, that being the right hand. Locks onto a single Rothana, just shakes him off.
Good takedown defense shown by Rothana so far. He's throwing a lot of volume with these kicks, but Ballard's doing a good job of defending these kicks as well. The aggression is definitely on show from Chan Rothana as one of those body kicks sneaks through the guard.
Gustavo Ballard has so many fans around the world following his one championship debut last time out where he lost a very close decision at Tatsumitsu Wada. Fans have been tweeting us all night that they've been looking forward to the Cuban, and here he is. Locks onto a single leg. There's an overhand left. Went for a second bite at it. Couldn't connect. Popping right hand there from Rothana and they break off. Jab to Rothana, full extension. You see though, Ballard is breathing heavy here in the third. This is the chance Rothana needs. Looks for a driving takedown, Ballard. Not quite what he wants. And manages to take the back though of Rothana. Rothana stands back up. Ballard wants him down the canvas.
Beautiful job by Rothana to work his way back up. Ballard was able to get him down, but Rothana popped right back up now. He's got to try to dig some underhooks. He's got to try to get his arms underneath the arms of Ballard so he can pry him up just like that. Good job by Rothana. Now he's got to try to turn the corner. Yep, gets away. You can see Ballard breathing real heavy. This could be Rotana's opportunity.
The Cuban has slowed down. This is where Rothana needs to go hell for leather.
You can see the mouthpiece just kind of dangling out there from Ballard. That's dangerous to do.
Ballard would have gotten this single leg down very quickly in the opening round. Took a lot longer here in the third. Rothana glances towards his corner across the circle. They want their man to get back up. They know that Ballard is exposed on the feet because he is tired. And Ballard will just grind him on the ground, shave the seconds off the clock with 1:50 remaining.
You can hear one championship superstar, featherweight Po Ta, screaming advice at his combatant, Chan Rothana, to work his way back up to his feet. And Chan Rothana does just that as Ballard is tenacious for that takedown. He's got 90 seconds left. Good job, Rothana, to push that head away. Let's see if he can keep it up.
And now we're back to the striking range for Chan Rothana, the kumkumai stylist. Launches the right hand. There's a wild uppercut. There's another one from Rothana. Needs more accuracy. So too with the left hand. Both men swinging now. But it's very arm-heavy punching from Gustavo Ballard. Takes a round kick to the ribs, Ballard. Eats a right hand, Ballard. He may be right for the picking now, Gustavo Ballard. And Rothana finished Ballard.
by Chan Rothana at the end of that third round. There was about 3 minutes of work put in by Chan Rothana as he emptied his gas tank. And but Bullard stood there eating it, taking it, absorbing the energy from Chan Rothana, and he had just enough left as Bullard tries to climb the gate, the top of the circle wall. And he says, ah, that's okay. I don't need to sit up there. I'll sit on your shoulders instead. Exceptional performance. Look at this. Chan Rothana just lit him up on the feet. But Bullard didn't back down at all, marching forward, putting everything into every single shot. Still had his defense up. Beautiful switch there as Rothana threw the right kick. The hand, the foot comes down, the right hand comes right across. Ah.
Let's go to Tom now and find out our winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner.
It's just been action-packed all night, Steve. Now, this is the final bout of the evening. I bet you they're going to kick it off for us.
Well, Zhou is 12-5 as a professional mixed martial artist. His opponent 9-2, but as I said,
beautiful inside leg trip there by Zhou to come end up on top, but Xie Wei with a nice bump reverses the position.
Xie Wei, 3-1 Hero Series wins, and that puts him in a great position.
Yeah, you'd have to think, Steve, with an impressive win tonight, it's going to catapult him to the top of the list.
Yeah, that would be the feeling. And what can Zhou do in opposition? At the moment, he's got his back to the canvas. But he's presenting a moving opponent. There he is, back up on his feet.
Whoa. Yeah, great use of the underhook by Zhou to pop back up to his feet. Use the underhook to come up the hip and work his way up.
Just looks a little untidy at times, Zhou. Overhand right there. Perhaps needs to just grab himself a little bit. Xie Wei, spinning elbow, that landed solidly. I must say, Xie Wei took that effortlessly.
Yeah, another takedown again by Zhou, but Xie Wei ends up on top for the second time now. But the thing with these unorthodox guys is they're always throwing strikes from nowhere. You can see that right before the takedown, he threw a kick and spun into a spinning back fist. It's so dangerous competing against guys like this. But oh no, Joe's giving up his back. Xie Wei locks up both hips, both hooks in now, flattens him out.
Now he's got to be careful with punches to the back of the head. That one looked like it was clean to the back of the head. That's determined by a blow that lands at the back and doesn't touch either ear.
Xie doing a good job applying pressure on Zhou's hips to keep him flat. But now Zhou's locking up Xie's wrist. Great job by Xie to come up the side. Beautiful work.
Forearm pressing down on the head there. And now the entire body on the head.
Xie Wei just taking his time, securing the position right now. Knows that Zhou is very explosive. Doesn't want to give him the space yet. Look at that. Zhou is looking for the underhook
Kimura
to get underneath.
Had a little look at the Kimura, I think, but he wasn't really in position.
He just pushed the handbound just to get the underhook, get his own underhook. He wants to keep him here to land some strikes, Steve. He's pinning both his arms, one with his head and shoulder, and one he wants to put it between his knees. They call it the crucifix position.
First 3 minutes of this bout has gone very quickly.
Xie Wei happy here, side control. Landing some little shots, taking his sweet time. Yeah, this is what he wants. He wants Zhou to expend energy and him to keep moving. You see how he's got the underhook on the other side?
Struggling to get off his back, but he does it. Now he covers up.
Yeah, great work by Xie, not moving too fast, taking his time.
Back to his feet, takes a knee to the head, and that's tremendous work by Zhou.
Zhou with another takedown, but Xie Wei on top for the third time now.
Yeah, Xie Wei is a difficult man to displace, isn't he?
Yeah, good work by Xie. He wants to keep his body flat. He wants to keep his back flat to the ground so he can't use his hips. But Zhou, so sneaky, so slippery.
Just digging in that right hand, but it gets caught by his opponent, so he can't pull it back and try again.
Yeah, good work by Xie. They're constantly breaking the base of Zhou. Every time he pops back up, he's going to move him, shift him one side or the other, break his posture down.
Again. Spinning back fist, all great stuff when they're on their feet, these two.
This is what I'm talking about, Steve. You gotta watch out when you're fighting a guy so unorthodox like this.
Mouth shield has come out and gets put back in. Oh, right hand, he put everything in that, so much so that he ended up falling himself. Well, he may have done. I think the momentum took him to the ground, but he's covering up. He's not fighting back.
He's not defending himself. He's just taking these shots. The referee might stop it here.
The referee doesn't have much option to stop it because nothing was coming back. And I think, Gianna, you might be right that he may have hurt himself before they got into that position. I'm not entirely sure how, but that would be consistent with what happened afterwards.
Xie Wei with a full display on tonight. Sprawls, takedowns, ground and pound. And good work to end the round over there. Was able to weather the storm that Zhou threw on him, but this is his work. On top, side control, land and some hard shots. Look at him, hip on the side, creating some angles, some leverage to throw his right hand. Constantly working.
I think you might be right. It might have been what happened before that that signaled the end of the contest. Regardless, Xie Wei improves his record in One Hero Series to 4-0. And that is a superb position for him to be in.
Winner!
There's the official decision, 4-0. Will he become a ONE Championship roster athlete?
Go!
Xie Wei, whoa! The recipient of a driving start from Rocky Bakhtol.
Oh, good right hand
by
Bakhtol.
They're really going at it, aren't they?
Bakhtol coming forward hard.
What happened to that feeling out period?
But we know Xie Wei's used to this type of bout.
Oh, left hand's decent from Bakhtol, uppercut. Sent Xie Wei's head right back. What a pace these two are setting. Got 15.
Oh, right hand drops Bakhtol.
Super right hand.
Bakhtol's hurt, Steve.
And he bounced straight back up. He's taken a knee to the head and an elbow subsequently, but he's still in there. I'm pretty sure there's a cut above his left eye, Gianni.
Oh, Bakhtol looks out of it, Steve.
I think
gonna
it might
stop
be
it here.
Coming to a close. Yeah, the referee jumped in. Whoa. What a quick one that was. And it was all action from start to finish. Didn't last long, but we saw about as much action there as we see in many bouts. That was something else.
Let's look at the finish here. This right hand drops Bakhtol. And from here, another uppercut, I think, Steve. Rocks Bakhtol. This is the finish again. Uppercut. That's the one that stumbles him and then just pours on the pressure. What a performance by Xie Wei here
and that,
to end the night.
It wasn't one-way traffic either. They were both giving it everything there, but in the end, it was Xie Wei who had the strength, had the penetration with those sharp blows through the guard.